Welcome to the Rusted Garden Homestead. This video is just about growing ginger indoors in flats. We're going to pot it up and getting it ready to go out into your garden. I just did a video on starting the ginger root, turmeric, and sweet potatoes in these flats, but I'm going to show you how to do the ginger again, just so that ginger can be in a single video. What I wanted to show you first is potting up the ginger that has been growing in these seed flats for about 9 weeks now. This was started on December 9th. It is February 17th, so that's 9 or 10 weeks. When you put in your ginger rhizome, and I'll show you how to do that, it's going to take anywhere, if you're lucky, 8 weeks to 12 weeks to start really growing to the point that we're going to take this. We're actually just going to break it off. The whole root system is there, and we're going to up-pot it into a container. This container can go to a southwest facing window. Believe it or not, ginger's not a tropical plant that loves tons of sun. That's what a lot of people think. It prefers partial shade, would actually like not to have full summer sun beating down on it. So you can put this right in a window, let it grow until it's ready to go out into your garden. You want it to go out into your garden when the temperature of the soil is 50 plus degrees and it's really starting to warm up. Now before we get to that, this is the final pot up of that larger piece of ginger. In case you are interested in growing vertically, these are green stalk towers. I am affiliated with them. This is in a custom color for the Rusted Garden. I call it the Rusted Garden Red. 5 tiers, 60 pockets, only 500 of this color have been made. There's only about 100 left. They went on sale last Thursday. If you're interested, check out the description. But the whole goal is to get your ginger growing in a nice pot, 3 months of growth. Some of the key things for ginger. In order to have a really nice harvest and get a nice rhizome, this needs to be growing in your garden 7 to 10 months. Not put this piece into your garden, it sits there for 3 months, and then it sprouts out like some of those. You want it to really take off and have full growth 7 to 10 months, and you're going to be able to harvest really nice rhizomes. When the frost comes, cold weather comes, ginger will get killed back. If you are in a zone where you don't have freezing temperatures, you can grow this a little bit differently. So we started indoors. This will probably go out into my garden late April, early May. You want to get 3 months of growth going inside. This way you get a jump on the season, and like I've been saying it several times, you'll get a great rhizome. So after this has been growing in the flat, I just dug it out of here, for 9 or 10 weeks, you can see that the root system, let me raise it up a little bit, is all growing right out of this main area. And you can get in with a knife. Look at that. That whole system is all attached right here. And I left my knife over there. I'm going to step away and grab it. And we're just going to cut it off right here. And now we have the perfect ginger plant to finish growing indoors. I mean, look at that root system. That's why you're growing it in here. 8 weeks of growth, 9 weeks of growth, 10 weeks of growth, and now it's going to finish up for February, March, much of April. I'm using these quart pouches. You want a larger container, let the root system really establish. I sell these at my seed shop. These can be reused. So I'm filling this about 3/4 the way and just packing it down nicely. You want a nice dense base for the roots to grow into. You want something about this size, maybe a little bit smaller. And you'll notice that I started in a seed flat. If you have the room and you can spread your ginger rhizomes and, you know, cuttings into here, you can go ahead and just grow in this and you don't have to pot up. But I have limited space, so I start them in a flat. I also start them in a flat because I want to make sure I get a lot of plants and I just don't have pots sitting around that aren't doing anything. You want to get the root system dropped down without disturbing it so much. And you're going to kind of have to judge it, like I need to take a little bit out of there. And just drop it in. You only want to bury the soil to about here, or bury the rhizome to about here, right where the green meets the white. Just gently tuck in the roots. There's no fertilizer in this starting mix. And then if you shake it a little bit, it helps get the soil around the roots. This is seed starting mix, set up with boiling water. It's cooled down now, but I use boiling water to get rid of fungus gnats. And this is all you do. This is going to get watered in now with a fish emulsion. I'm just going to use a water-soluble fertilizer, and this plant is well on its way. For transplanting, you want it to get to something like this size where it gets a leaf and it's branching out. This is ready to go and it's ready to grow. And you saw the beautiful root system. So again, south-southwest facing window will get some sun. You're going to just keep it fed every 2 weeks with a little bit of fish emulsion and keep this moist. Don't over soak or saturate it. This will continue to grow from today, February 17th, towards the end of April. I'll start transitioning it outside and it'll get into my garden around then. But this is what you want. You want to get a good solid 3 months of growth in your house, in your greenhouse if you have it. So I think this is a beautiful ginger plant. And again, I like starting them in these flats because you can see all the growth that's coming up. And this one's getting there. Once they get to like this height, they really take off. So in about 5 days, this will be ready to go in. And I just pull up the different rhizomes and break off what I need. Now, this is the one I just took that plant off of. It has another growth starting here. So I'm just going to gently scrape away where it was. You can see other roots are in there. Drop it back down. Cover it up. And just let it finish what it's doing. So, if you go to any store, I got these at Costco, they're organic, your rhizomes are gonna look something like this. You're gonna cut them down into 1 to 2 inch pieces, and you're looking for these little horns or little, you know, they're not really spiky, but you can see what I mean, like right there. That's where the plant's going to grow out of it. It's going to root out. Again, you could just start these in a bunch of pouches or containers if you want, but I like doing it this way. So a flat, fill it up halfway, press it down, no fertilizers in there, and I just drop these on the outside, and then if I have more, I'll put some down the middle. Now, well, I already did this. I guess I should explain this point. Put them in water at night, let them sit in there, and then you can just put in, you know, let them hydrate overnight. Put in about that much hydrogen peroxide the day of that you're going to be putting them into the flat, and just swish it around. That will clean off any kind of mold or issues on there. If you skip that step, it's okay, but it's always good to have nice sterile rhizomes, and it would look something just like that. I'll cover it up with the rest of my starting mix, press it in, water it whenever you need to. The top will dry first. You want it to stay damp. You're gonna have to wait 6 to 8 weeks to see any kind of growth going. If you are curious, you can always dig some back, see if the roots are starting, but somewhere between, I don't know, 8-10 weeks, you should see stuff sprouting up and you're good to go. I keep it under my lights while it's doing its thing. It doesn't have to have 12 hours of light, but you can put it wherever you want until you start seeing the greenery break through, and then get it, you know, to somewhere where there's light, get it growing. So you want to get this started indoors, let it do its thing for 3 or 4 months and really establish. This will get transplanted into the garden. I simply just take a sharp knife, cut around here because these fabric pots will do root pruning, and then I pop it out, it goes into the garden. You don't want to be putting the cut rhizomes at 1 to 2 inches into your garden, let's just say in March, early April, thinking that that's part of the 2 months, 3 months of the growing time. It's not. It's just going to sit there and it's not going to do a whole lot. That's why you're doing it inside. And again, if you're in a place where you have no frost or very little frost and it stays warm for 8-10 months, you can probably plant right into the garden, but most of us can't do that. And again, if you want to subscribe to the channel, ring the bell. I do all my videos in a real-time series. I'll be showing you how I plant this in the garden, how I tend it, and then I'll show you the final harvest. But this is all you really need to do to get ginger set up. When you purchase it, it's going to be in something about this size, and again, you're just looking through the 1 or 2 inch pieces, and you're looking for the little horn that you can see right there. That's usually where the greenery is going to grow out of. If you encounter pieces of the rhizome that are dried or shriveled, you know, don't use those. Use them for cooking or something like that. This is all you need to do to get ginger started indoors. Get it growing. You're going to have a massive harvest come the end of the season. Thanks so much for watching, and please check out my seed shop at therustedgarden.com.